Here we go, people. This is the first match of KWX here. I am Marcus Baker, and these two men are locking up Andre Rain and the Ace. Goodness gracious, he's got him locked up tight. It's all man Andre versus Ivan. As I said before about the background of these two men here, this is for the Billlion Championship here. Whoa! Oh my gosh, that was oh my goodness! Nice shoulder block there from Andre Rain. Throws Andy Ace out the ring, sent him out of here. Sent that man packing onto the concrete. I don't know what Andre's going for, a kick, and oh goodness gracious, what a spinning heel kick that was. And a big insecurity. Goodness whip, oh man. Andy Ace, oh, he's going for the toys. He's got a table. Andre, better watch out. Oh, who took a shot and another one to the gut. Oh my gosh, this is what I said before. Andy Ace is the risk taker. Oh goodness, Andre Rain is not having it. Andre Rain is not having it. Goodness gracious, Andy Ace better think about his decisions here. Because goodness, he could have just got tripped like that. What is this? A scoop slam? No! What a flow over DDT that was, reversing out that scoop slam, and Andy Ace is torn. I don't think that's a good idea. Look at that big neck breaker. Like I said, he took too much time wasting. Oh my gosh, look at this stretch here. This back stretch right here. Goodness. Oh no, I thought we were going to see Andy Ace tap here. Oh my gosh, that was going to be a big club. But Andy Ace reverses that. These men are going back and forth. This quick style match here. Big low kick to the chest of Andy Ace. My goodness, this is an actually great match that we're seeing right here. And this is only just the beginning here, people. Oh man, what a kick. Like I said, Andre Rain is a quick, strong style fighter here. This man is quick with his feet. I thought we were going to see a two count, but no. Andre Rain has to pull off more for Andy Ace. Andy Ace is a resilient man. As I said before of Andy Ace. Oh my gosh, what a big cutter. Goodness, send Andy Ace on the mat here. Andy Ace, now like I said, I knew you got, when you taunt in the ring against a quick style guy like Andre Rain, you better be ready for anything that he gives you. This man is quick. That taunt that Andy Ace pulled earlier backfired. What a backstabber that was. And here to the pin. And a one count once again. Andre Rain better. You better show some improvement here. Now another knee strike that Andy Ace just countered. A big, he was about to go for a solo kick. He counters. Oh my gosh, what a backstabber. Like I said, this quick style that you see from Andre Rain, it's just normal. It's normal to this man. This guy has trained with his father. His father was a kickboxer. Andre Rain was a lone child. When his father died, he carried the legacy to go across the world, join fights, beat up people, all for money to survive. Every tattoo you see on Andre Rain, that was his attempt to let go of the pain. Every, goodness, just think about how many hours that is. Like, goodness gracious, just a big two after that huge super kick. I knew that super kick was not going to do nothing. Oh my gosh, a roll up here by Andy Ace. Two. No, oh my goodness. Close claw. Goodness. I'm sorry if I said claw there, people. Sometimes when you see great action like this, it takes the words right out of your mouth. Big club to the back and a big knee strike. Send him away and Andy Ace is going crazy. This guy. Both of these men have turned like so much energy built into them. Oh goodness, cross body. Gosh. Andre Rain was begging for him to jump and Andy Ace sure as hell did. Just amazing right there. Oh man, big low kick to the back. Goodness gracious. Oh, what is this? Oh man, he has the knee just stretching his neck back. Oh my gosh, wow, what a nice gut punch. Oh man, a big roundhouse kick. Jesus Christ, is this man out? No, the fuck he isn't. A one count. Andre cannot believe it. Goodness, man. This is crazy. Another spinning heel kick and another one. Goodness gracious. The thing is about Andy Ace, the more you attack him, the more he's going to get faster. He's going to get stronger and try to pull out bigger moves. What a miss there. I don't know where Andy Ace was going to go for. Another backstabber. Goodness gracious. Oh my gosh, Andre Rain going for the body now, and we don't even know what he's about to go for. He's setting up for something. Is it the brain buster? What a twist right there. Oh my god, on Andy Ace's neck. Unbelievable. One, it gotta be over. Two. Oh my gosh. A pissed off Andre Rain just cannot believe that Andy Ace is kicking out. But like I said before, Andy Ace was a skateboarder and a soccer player in his time as a child. He had so many injuries, and every time he kept coming back stronger and went for more tricks, more and more and more. The more he kept getting hurt, the more he kept fighting. That's the thing. What is going on? Oh my god! What? This was that a curb stomp? Jesus Christ! Send his face on the mat, and like I said before, the mat is no easy. That shit is not no pillow. I'm just being honest here with you. I just can't believe what Andre Rain just pulled off here. Both these men are giving each other suicidal shots. What is this? Oh my god, Andre Rain! Goodness, man, Andre Rain protected himself. And he used his feet, his strong style feet, to break the table so he won't have to take much impact from the fall. Good move. Good move and quick to go. Andy Ace now setting up for another table spot. He's trying to do what he was going to do earlier. And then, oh my gosh, Andre Rain is not fucking having it. What a scoop slam and a leg drop. Oh my gosh. Big kick to the gut there by Andre Rain. What is Andre going for? He's setting up for something. He's turning him around. And a big suplex! God! The neck! The neck of Andy Ace. That's it. It is over. This man has been put through a table. Oh my gosh! Andy Ace just kicked out from that? He just kicked out from that twisted teardrop back suplex. Jesus. I don't even know if that was a teardrop or not. It was just so quick. He blocked the roundhouse kick. Big elbow to the back. Pushed him all the way to the corner. What is this? A big STO onto the middle of the turnbuckle. My gosh. And the Ace is on fire. Like I stated before, man, this guy, he does not care. Oh, my gosh. What a big elbow drop to the legs. Now picking him up. What is Andy Ace going for? Andy Ace is pumped up! Like, I don't understand that. This guy is crazy. I don't think Andre can come back from this. What is Andy Ace going for? Jesus Christ, what a tope that was. Big tope, the crowd is going crazy here tonight. Just amazing. Jeez. Oh my gosh, that is insane. Andre's out cold. What is Andy Ace going for? He's got a steel chair. He's breaking the toys out, I'll tell you that. Remember, this is chaos. Oh my gosh! Andre Rain is not fucking having it. What a big kendo stick to the back. Do you hear the shots? Do you hear it? Jeez! Oh my gosh, what a big single leg drop kick that was. Sending Andre Rain off his feet, and what a smooth. You see how that move was so quick and smooth? That it just took this man off his feet. The thing is about Andy Ace is that he has a lot of style with his moves. everything is smooth and calculated well. With Andre Reign, everything is rough and aggressive. And I think these two men, in some weird way, they have a similarity. And I don't know if it's the quickness or the strike style, but these big right hands that just sent Andre Reign to the corner. And again, not this STO by Andy Hayes. Jesus. My goodness, man. What a match this is in KWX. What the fuck? Oh, gosh. Good thing that elbow pad was black, because you can see the sweat marks just on that elbow pad after that knee strike. Jeez. Where is Andy? Oh, my gosh. Jesus Christ. Andre Reign's head just hit that turn. Just hit that chair that was stuck onto the turnbuckle. He knocked it straight out the ring. That chair is broken. I'm gonna just slide it just under this announce table. Jesus. Oh my gosh. What a flip over clothesline that was. Man, Andre Reign is taking these shots. And Andy Ace is getting stronger. Like I said, the more he's doing, the more he's gonna do big. Big shock there. Andre Reign is just taking this in. Oh my gosh, what a big elbow strike. Andre Reign's trying to come back. Big roundhouse. That's it. This man is down. Andy Ace is down. Oh my god. He kicked out before the two count was even made. After all that, this man's stamina is still on the 100? Jesus Christ. What is Andy going for here? Oh my god. What's that, a small package driver? Jesus, the neck of Andre. Andre kicks. Oh my fucking gosh. Andre Reign just kicked out of a small package driver. My goodness. These men are not giving no fucks. They are putting it all in just for this billion-dollar championship and to get managed by the billion-dollar man himself. This is just unbelievable. Like I said, these men have a huge background. And no matter what, it all comes with fighting and surviving. And these men are sure pulling it off. Jesus, man. I'm sorry about this, people. If it's too violent for you, a two count. And after that big suplex on the top rope, Andre kicks out of that? I'm sorry, Andy kicks out of that. My goodness, see, I'm getting lost the words here because of how great these performers are. Like I said, KWS, we might see more people like this in the future. Jesus Christ, just hammering with the kicks. Like I said, look how quick and aggressive those kicks are that Andre Reign is presenting to Andy. Oh my gosh, Andy, with that running single leg drop kick. He's dazed. Andre's dazed. He's dazed. He sends him onto the corner. What is going on? Oh my gosh, no. What is this? The fuck he's about to... Oh my god. What did we just see? He just powerbombed Andre's neck onto that turnbuckle. Made out of steel, a Phoenix splash! My god! What a corkscrew splash that was! Jesus, that's it! Andre is done! And a three! Andy Ace is going to the next round! What a match! Andy Ace was just... It was just too much. He just caught Andre too much with that match. I do not know what was going on with Andre. Just look at the super kick. It's just the shots that he gave him was just too much. Oh my goodness, man. The thing is, when you pin a man after that, it's just that they become, you have to beat your opponent till they're unconscious. And Andre, after getting his neck just slammed onto that turnbuckle, I'll be knocked the fuck out too. Andre tried to come back, but it's like Andy Ace is like, he's like a fucking car. You can't stop it. My goodness. Jeez, man. I did not know that Andy Ace was going to show this much tonight. but I am happy to say that this man deserves it all. This is KWS, people. We still got a show to fucking go. But anyways, you guys, on to the next match of KWX. We have more superstars on the way. Welcome back to KWS after that commercial break. And I must say, the reason why we go to commercial break is to clean up the mess that scatters around this ring due to the chaos. And here we go, we're setting up to this match. Another round for the $1 billion championship. Here we go. We have none other than another newcomer, JT Pitbull. In case you don't know about this young superstar, he grew up poor. He is a Philippine-American. Think about it. A poor kid in Los Angeles, California. I gotta say, he grew to the top and he became a professional wrestler. And he did it all. And what the f... Is this... Wait, I can't see. It's Joshua Radix. He's not supposed to be out here yet. What the hell? And oh my God! JT Pitbull jumped down because he felt something. Oh my... What the fuck is this guy doing here? A big kick to the chest. This guy's screaming like a banshee. He's telling him to get up. Look at that. He's making sure he's okay and shit. Look at this. This is unbelievable. I understand this is hard. This is hardcore. You gotta make a name for yourself in this business, but this is just unbelievable here. Come on now. Big shots to the face. Oh my gosh. Oh, what a reversal. My gosh. What a tilt-a-whirl arm drag that we just saw from JT Pitbull. If I was JT, I would get that. Yes, exactly what I was going to say. Grab a weapon and beat the shit. Oh, my gosh. What a dropkick. I got to say, with Joshua Radix, in case you don't know, this is what you call the cocky nerd. Joshua Radix has won titles across the indie scene by just... He's the cheapest, dirtiest guy in the game. Oh my God, what a big shot. Did you just hear that? This kid's skull is cracking, and where is he going for? Fisherman driver onto the concrete! Jeez, this is just a relentless, brutal attack that we're seeing here. Oh man, I feel like JT Pitbull should have done some research on the guy he's facing tonight. But this is why JT Pitbull is well known in America, in the indie scene, due to how he fights and he keeps going. And oh my gosh, what an arm wrench into that big boot. Gosh, look at that, just checking himself. Look at that, just throwing this stuff. Look at these three idiots. Their mics are not even plugged in. Taken out the table. What is Joshua planning to do? Big slap to the face. JT Pitbull, I gotta say, this kid has to recover. If he recovers and takes a win, I don't know what Joshua might do. He might even break this whole set. Because Joshua Radix, when he was a teenager, he blew up his own school. And he admitted it on fucking Facebook that he did it. And he had no jail time for it. This kid gets away with crimes, and this kid gets away with W's. Just unbelievable. I gotta say, Joshua, oh my gosh, what a nice, nice knee strike. Good low kick, blocked by Joshua. Not a German suplex onto the concrete. This is just sad. Joshua's focused on the head. JT might be blood. Oh my God, speaking of blood, he's busted wide open now. I knew that was going to happen soon enough. What is this, a pile driver? That is what I'm talking about. You're going to have to do it. You're going to have to pull off the big guns, especially if your opponent is more healthier and more faster than you, or has a more advantage into the match. You're going to have to start bringing out the big toys. Oh my gosh. Payback is a bitch for Joshua Radix right now. Getting getting demolished by those steel steps. Like I said before, sometimes it just leaves me speechless what these guys can do in the ring. JT Pitbull is fast. He's real fast, but Joshua is too. But the thing is, he's a... Oh my gosh, another one. Another arm reach into that big boot. Slamming him onto the mat. This is just crazy. And JT Pitbull keeps fighting. JT Pitbull, I gotta say, he's been through the struggles. He's been through everything in his life. He always done it for his mom and for his family. A Filipino American. Oh my god, just threw the steel chair. Oh my gosh, another... Oh! This is just disgusting. This is truly just disgusting here. But I have to commentate on this because this is what the... This is what I'm getting paid for. This is just sad. This is savage. This is just savage. Goodness gracious, this is just... Now he's gonna get more weapons. Just end it already. Just end this. Oh my gosh, a single leg dropkick. Take it down. Oh goodness, good block, but not enough. Not quick enough. JT Pitbull is down and he's out. And a single knee face buster. Oh my god, that took a lot right there out of Joshua, but not enough for him to be tired. JT Pitbull, you see the blood that's laying on that steel chair. Just craziness right here. What's Joshua going for? He better not go for that shoulder jawbreaker. He's setting up. He wants him to recover. He wants him to see. Oh my gosh! Jumping complete shot onto that steel chair. Talk about making a name for yourself. One, just, it's over. My God. Like I said before, I don't know who these men are, but I know their background. They wouldn't be signed to KWX if I don't know shit about them. Goodness. These guys, they pull off so much. You don't know who is going to win. JT Pitbull probably at any moment can put his JT clutch. All he has to do is do that. I think Joshua might tap. Because Joshua's a little bit tired himself. Oh my gosh. Yes! JT Pitbull! He's back in it! And a big kendo stick to the back of Joshua. I don't know if that kendo stick is really going to hurt him that much. He's wearing a fucking t-shirt and a single leg dropkick again. Sending JT Pitbull onto the ground once more. He's done it like three times this match. Even Andy Ace pulled off a single leg dropkick similar to that. Oh, come on. What is he going for? This is just sick. This is sick. Just end this match. And he's choking him. He's choking JT Pitbull with the kendo stick. My gosh. I'm sorry if I'm saying the same words here, but this is sad. Do you hear the shots? Do you see the violence? Over a $1 billion championship. What money can do to a human. Joshua Radix now. Goodness. Oh my gosh. Not again. And he missed the table, but still got the move in. That jumping complete shot. My gosh, just look how smooth that is. You can tell he's done that on a lot of opponents. It's over. It's a three count. It is over, and this match needed to be over. Just unbelievable. He has the nerve to wear a Michael Jordan shirt. After what he did, that wasn't great. That was just savagery. A coward way to earn your keeps. And going on to the next round, I want to see how Joshua is going to do against someone like Andy Ace. I think he's probably not even going to make it. It's just unbelievable here. You've seen what this guy can do. And my goodness, He made a name for himself tonight. Hate him or love him, he made a name for himself. We'll see you guys on to the next round. This is Marcus Baker telling you to buy none other than WWE
2K17. This game is broken!
Experience none other than Suplex City with our fantastic engine gameplay. This is so sad. This is literally my first match on this game. And look at Del Rio. Look at the ref behind him. They're black. Look at Paige. This is so crazy. This is my first match, bro. This is what you give me, 2K? My God. Facing against other players are none other than 2K tonight. How do you fuck up the menu of 2K tonight? How, bro? How? In Suplex City, you can't beat the beast unless you change your movesets.
Dude, like, how the fuck you got... This game is so fucking broken, bruh. Like, dude, how the fuck... How can you fuck up the moveset? Like, how can you fuck up? Like, this shit glitches so many fucking times. That is unbelievable right there, bruh. Look at this! Look where I'm at! Motherfuckers telling me this is a good game?
Create your player to have an all new story in my career. Oh, this attire though. What the? Alright, that looks good. Wait. I can't. Are you serious? Do not. Oh my. I'm glitched. Do you hear the button? I'm pressing the shit out of the fucking circle button. Oh my God, bro. Are you kidding me? How do you glitch this? How? Oh my God, this game is so broken. Explore Suplex City with our all new My Career. Damn, hey, I gotta keep reversing me every time. How did I not block that, man? Goodness. Are you serious? Wait. They didn't fix this from last year? Oh my gosh, bro! Are you serious? Are you serious? But if I leave, I'm gonna lose this match! Oh my God, bro! Fucking. Oh, we had this game for one day, bro! Oh, we had this game for one day! Come on, bro! Are you serious? Oh my God, bro! You said I'm so happy I didn't pay no $60 for this, bro. I'm so glad I waited till the price dropped. This is crazy. This is I'm so done. I'm so fucking done. Buy WWE 2K17 today, and also be on the lookout for WWE 2K18. It will be the best. Welcome back to KWX, people. Marcus Baker here with the entire crowd cheering on for the next round, for the next part of violence here tonight in KWX. And here he is. This is another competitor that has indeed signed with KWX. Oh, gosh, what an explosion. And that is Logan Stark. Logan Stark has changed his life completely. In a sense of way that, you know, like, this guy just got big. He got tired of being bullied, and he said to himself, his main goal was to prove to everybody that he will be the best. He will prove everybody in his hometown that he will make something out of himself. But let's see if his dream can come true here tonight. Oh my gosh, look at that scream. Thing is about Logan Stark is that this guy, he's serious, but sometimes when it's like a a good fight ahead. You know, he'll start smirking. As you can see right now, he's smirking. But who is Logan Stark's competitor? What is going to happen here tonight? I gotta tell you, Logan Stark is a great competitor here in many other promotions. But he signed with KWX to be in the man's club, as he calls it. Be on the top tier brand. And who is this? Oh my goodness, it is Silver. Silver is here. What the hell? Oh my goodness. Logan Stark, he doesn't want to wait till this guy goes into the ring. He wants the action right now. And Silver, he wants to talk to him like, oh my goodness. The difference is about Logan Stark and Silver right now is that, just look at the size difference. It is not just the size difference. Silver is a main guy who really loves to put people on their heads. And what I mean by on their heads, give them brain buster after brain buster until they're knocked out. Pump handle, neck breakers, you name it. If it surrounds your head, you're screwed. And oh my goodness, man, what a big shove right there to the by Silver. And oh my gosh, nice arm drag, nice flip arm drag. Oh my gosh! Did you see that body push he just did to Silver? Just unbelievable. Now throwing him. Oh my Jesus. Throwing him onto the damn barricade. Oh, what a headbutt. This is what I'm talking about here. Logan Stark. The thing is, what you see, this man, it's like the more bigger he gets, the more he's becoming what he hated as a kid. He's becoming an asshole. He's thinking that every challenge is going to be easy like this. No. I don't know what's to come in KWX. I don't know what challengers are going to be up ahead. All I can know is certain names, but it's the faces that I have to know about. And goodness, man, Silver tried to do a smart thing, go for a weapon and take the big guy down, but Logan Stark is strong. The thing is, Logan Stark carries a lot of mysterious moves, you know? This guy can do some crazy shit. The thing is how the fuck he's gonna do in a big bat to the right side of fucking Silver's skull. My goodness, stomping away on him, lifting him up like trash, and another throw onto the barricade. This time Silver is able enough to stand on his 2 feet, but not for fucking long. Not for long. Logan Stark is giving this man nothing but punishment. I think he's just making him wish to not be in this tournament. Look at the webs that's on this man's chest. My goodness. And a big German suplex. This is what I'm talking about. This is Silver right here. No matter what move it may be, this man will go after the head. This man will have your skull crack the hell open. He will use hella brain busters if he has to. The crazy thing about Silver is just another guy who wants to prove to himself that he can go along the big boy league. He can overcome the extreme. He can learn this. It's basically a new style for Silver. He's more of a, you know, a normal match type of guy, not a hardcore base. He's hit a few chair shots. He's put a few through tables. But now, this is a challenge right here. Look at this. My goodness, he just did a nice leg snap. And oh my gosh, Logan Stark going after the leg with that single leg Boston Crab. Oh my gosh. Silver's screaming. He's trying to move, but all that body weight is just on him by Stark. My goodness, this hold is still on. And Stark just let go. Stark just let go. He's like, okay, this guy is fucking punished. And look at that. He's just starting now. He's pumping himself up in the ring. He's screaming. He's not even caring about Silver. And Silver now. Oh my goodness, what a shin breaker. This is like I said, he's become what he hates. My goodness. And of course you're going to get a one count, Silver. Silver's just tired at this moment. The thing is, it's not too much about Silver's background due to that he just wanted to be a wrestler. He wanted to be like the greats that fought so much in the golden era. He wants to be like those guys, but he wants to make it. Oh my God, look at this. This is unbelievable. Swinging this man like a damn rag doll, like a Barbie doll toy. Look at this. This is just unbelievable. Swinging this man like an action figure. My goodness. Unbelievable. And screaming like a lion. My goodness. Oh, not another fucking table. Goodness, we seen a lot of crazy table shit tonight. My goodness. Just, oh my gosh! Rolling elbow, Stark tried to grab him. Silver said, fuck that. And just did a nice rolling elbow. He thought that would have took out Logan Stark. It didn't. Logan Stark is up before him! My gosh! Oh no! Oh my, what the hell? What a cyclone. What a fucking fireman's carry face buster that was. My gosh. He's setting up the table. What is this man trying to do? He's trying to end this man's career on his first fucking night. He's trying to pull a Joshua Radix. Jeez. But this time he brought the fight to Silver. So early. So unexpected. I don't think Silver can recover. Oh my gosh! Silver did recover. I misjudged the kid a lot. Here's another suplex. My goodness. Silver, if I was you, man, I would be on patrol. I would go after every single part of this man's body. Oh my God, here it goes. This is what I'm talking about. Pump handle neck breaker, man. Sitting this man down. Two. Oh my God. That's a one count? Goodness, man. Logan Stark just went through a table. Logan Stark just went to the table and endured a pump handle neck breaker to the back of his skull, and he kicks out one. This is what I'm talking about. This is the strength of what this man has. This man has so much resiliency onto the fucking bank, and oh my gosh, what a jawbreaker. Sending Silver off his damn feet. What was Logan Stark trying to go for? Silver is too tired. He's too tired. Oh my gosh. No, what is this? Oh, that was a suplex power driver that we see from JT Pitbull. But Baruch capitalized. Wait, no. Standing moonsault. Oh my God. Putting the finishing touches. 2, 3 is over. We seen that move from JD Pitbull, but it was on the outside. It looked like the move had more effect. But Logan Stark mixed it up a little bit and gave us a standing moonsault. Like I said, you don't know what you're going to see from this guy. For real, Logan Stark, his background, and so is Silver's. It's not really too much that you can really give out. You know, Logan Stark, you know, he's trained and he's basically put guys on their necks, even to the hospital. But goodness, you gotta give it to Silver. Silver tried his best to do what he does best. Put motherfuckers on their head. But it wasn't enough. Stark was too energized. And look at that. Just smiling and smirking and telling the ref to fuck off. But Logan Stark makes it to the next round. Let's see who is the next competitors for the $1 billion championship. So here we go here. It was quick enough because there wasn't too many toys in the ring in the previous match. But, oh, here we go here. Chris Cordona, in case you don't know who Chris Cordona is. Chris Cordona, I must say, my man, Chris Cordona is indeed, in fact, a wrestling-based guy. This guy does have a few traits. He rolls around like he's a fucking video game character, I tell you that. And Chris Cordona, he can endure punishment. You know, he is a basic wrestler. And this kid is rookie level, but let's see how he's going to do here tonight. But I got to say, Chris Cordona does show that he can fight. He looks a bit nervous here tonight. Looks really nervous, but he's pumped. He's pumped enough to go out here and face his next opponent for the $1 billion championship. So let's go here. Who is Chris Cordona going to fight? Chris Cordona, I must say, is a unique guy. Oh my goodness! Dynamite Davey! Jeez. My goodness. Dynamite Davey is showing up here in KWX. My goodness. Like I said, I only know the backgrounds of these men. And let me just tell you, with Dynamite Davey, the thing is, I do not know why Dynamite Davey wanted his name to actually be like this. But Dynamite Davey said it's to trick their opponent and just fool them. And that's kind of smart. A nice small way to let people know your name. But here we go here, Chris Cordona and Dynamite Davey here. Let's go. Oh my gosh, Chris Cordona has him onto the corner here. The ref has to separate them. What? Goodness. These men they weren't going to let go? Goodness, now Dynamite Davey's got Chris Cordona. Got him against the ropes. Oh man, Irish Whip out the ring already! Chris Cordona has, in his past, he has a whole trophy room just full of trophies. And let me just say, I've seen a pic of it on Instagram, and oh my gosh! Did you see that right hand sending David onto the announce table? Throws him back into the ring. Look at this lock here. That calf killer he's got him in. That elbow strike, trying to get out the move, and now onto a suplex. Goodness, this is going to be a great match, people. I can tell by how these men are. They're fast, they're agile, and these guys we're going to give out lethal strikes. I gotta tell you, their strike game is on point. Their grapple game is on a fucking A+. These guys are going to fucking give us a show. And this is what the billion-dollar man wanted. And an enziguri already. Just look at this. This man's striking each other. Oh, my God. Look at the strength of Dynamite Davey. Deadlifting Chris Cordona like fucking trash. Oh, my gosh. Just deadlifted this man. Chris Cordona's big enough to come in the ring. And a big drop kick. Oh, my goodness. Oh, what's Chris Cordona going for? No, and a shoulder thrust. Davey reverses out of that. Gives Chris Cordona a shoulder thrust. Oh, my. Did you see that? Did you see that right hook? My goodness, a German suplex. He's about to German suplex Chris Cordona's skull oh, my gosh. Oh, a steel chair. I had to stop myself because, goodness, I knew that you was going to hear that. You was going to hear Davey's body hitting that chair, and it sure as hell did. My goodness, look at this wrestling hold. This wrestling hold now. Chris Cordona's focusing on the body here. Oh, my gosh, nice arm. We're sending Chris Cordona off his feet. And a steel chair shot. Well, he was going to get this sooner or later. But, goodness, come on, Davey. Jeez, he's fighting like a fucking, like a random guy on the street. And a big dropkick. Chris Cordona tried to fight out of it. But he's still feeling that pain off those steel chair shots. Now, Dynamite Davey's just kicking the shit out of him. My goodness. Oh, what a right hand. What a right hand. Dynamite Davey is a fucking fight night brawler. I must say, this Dynamite Davey, I gotta tell you, he's fought in bars. He's fought everywhere. This guy can fucking fight. He is a veteran, a World War veteran. Goodness. And what I mean by veteran, this guy plays fucking Call of Duty a lot. So when you got guys like this, he knows how to talk trash. And a big two count here after that move. The thing is about Dynamite Davey, which you got to understand, Dynamite Davey is a guy not to be fucked with. Seriously, and him changing his name to something like that is crazy. And a steel chair. No, look at. Oh my gosh! Dynamite Davey blocked out of it. Oh my gosh! This man's vision he's on A game with that. If I would give Dynamite Davey an overall, I would give this man a fucking 99 overall. That's how fucking impressive and crazy, and the ability level of what this guy can do is insane. But Chris Cordona, we really don't know too much about his ability. All we know that he is a wrestler and a striker. Let's see if he can impress us with those, with any move, any caliber to put on Davey, to try to get the pin on Davey in this match. Big right hands and kicks, my goodness. Davey's just trying to throw Chris Cordona onto that table. Chris Cordona's not fucking having it. Oh my gosh, these kicks, these right kicks to the gut of Chris Cordona. Davey looks tired. Oh my goodness. I know Chris Cordona tried to go after the body, but now Davey's doing the game plan of what Chris tried to do. Big right hand. Goodness, man. Oh my gosh. Sending Chris Cordona onto that barricade. Put his head onto that steel barricade. Look at these strikes these men are giving each other. My goodness. Oh, look at that hatch suplex. Davey's fucking tired. But not too tired. My goodness. That move right there. Oh my gosh. I'll be fucking tired too if I just gave strikes like that. Goodness, man. The pain is it's probably written all over Chris Cordona's face. Chris Cordona just, what the fuck? He just got up like it was nothing. Oh my gosh, what a T-bone suplex. Chris Cordona is pumped. Chris Cordona is pumped. Oh my gosh, what a left hand, a right hand, and another right. These lethal strikes. Oh my gosh, what a drop kick. And a single leg kick. Davey's still fucking standing. And a barricade sending Davey's body onto that steel. Oh my gosh, that took down Davey. Oh my gosh. Whoa, shit. Chris Cordona is looking like a fucking 85 overall right now. Oh my gosh, big kitchen sink. Got Dynamite Davey in that snapman position. Now on single leg. Now kick, now punching him in the fucking face. Standing man to man, not no more, my gosh. Another drop kick. This man is sending fucking this wrestling veteran, Dynamite Davey, off his fucking feet. My goodness, you're going to have to give this kid credit. Double exhale to the back of Dynamite Davey. Oh my, send him into the ring. You might as well, kid. You might as well send him fucking punch to the face. My goodness, man. This Chris Cordona, he's impressing me tonight. He's impressing the fans. Oh, jeez. Not another table. Not a table. We've seen too much of those tonight. Oh, my gosh. What an arm-wrench flip that was. Chris Cordona seems tired just picking up that table after giving so many moves to... Oh, my gosh! What a DDT that was onto the edge of that table. Which involves steel. And what is this? What is this cross? He has him in some type of cross lock. Oh my gosh. Is Chris Cordona going to tap out of this? Is he going to tap out of this? I just want to motherfucking know. Oh my gosh. Big fucking. Big rock him, sock him to the back. What is this? Oh no. Dynamite. Dynamite trying to go for something. Chris Cordona flips out of it. Now giving him more lethal strikes. He's punching the hell out of this man. Look at the bruise on his face. What a drop down. JV's like, fuck that. Oh my gosh. Spinning back punch. Oh my gosh. Now Davey's fucking pumped up. Chris Cordona just couldn't believe. Chris Cordona hit the ref for a bit. Oh my goodness. Oh, what a flying elbow. What a motherfucking flying elbow, my people. This shit is unbelievable. Another diving foot stomp. Jeez. Took the breath off Chris Cordona. It's over. No! I don't know what to say. I truly don't know what to say, people. Fucking flying clothesline. Send this man onto that turnbuckle. Oh, my goodness. I can tell these guys are not going to quit. They're not going to quit. You think these guys, it's going to take them a while before they... Oh, my goodness. It's going to take these men a while to get readjusted. with the surroundings. They got a lot of fucking toys to play with before the other man is unconscious. Chris Cordana, is he trying to contemplate whether he should use the, oh, fuck it. He ain't thinking about it no more. He ain't thinking about using that steel chair or not. Turning his back on being that fair fighter, the guy that really don't touch weapons. Oh my gosh, another steel chair shot. This man is bloodied. Do you see the blood stains that are on that steel chair? Punching him in the face, my goodness. Chris Cordana's giving these men the rights. He's giving them the fucking rights. The fight night round rights that you're seeing here. Chris Cordana's pumped. Do you see the blood that is on Chris Cordana's hand? Oh my goodness. Now onto the table. Oh my gosh. This is the shit you have to do to Dynamite Davey. You have to push this man to the fucking limits. Oh, no, he tried to hit him with that. He tried to hit him with the gut. With that steel chair. No, another deadlift wrench. How the fuck is Davey getting the strength of that? Goodness. What's Davey going for? Oh, my. Is he going for his... He's going for the butterfly power drive. He's trying to break this fucking kid's neck. Oh, yo. My gosh, this kid's neck is done. It's done. Chris Cordana's out cold. Kid, you tried, but not enough. It is over. Oh! Oh, shit, he kicked out. He fucking kicked out Chris Cordana. This kid's got a lot of fucking heart. Davey's pissed the fuck off with that crazy single leg kick to the back of Chris Cordana. Has him in another snapmare position. Breaking the neck. Oh my gosh. Davey can't fucking believe that shit. He's pissed. Davey's fucking pissed. Oh my gosh, man. What an arm lock stomp that was. My goodness. Not sending him off to the corner. What is Davey thinking? What is that? No. Come on, Davey. Davey, he better not go for that fucking brain buster. He better not go for that brain buster. What is Davey thinking? What is he thinking about? Well, no, he's not. Wait. Oh, my gosh! What an avalanche fucking arrow that was! Chris Cordana's out cold! No! No, no, no! Chris Cordana's fucking up before Davey! Davey's tired! Yo, gut kick! And what is this? Another inverted power slam! What the fuck was that? Jesus! That inverted power slam! Look at the force he had with that! What is this move? It's like some type of inverted sharpshooter, and Davey's taking the fucking punishment! A bloody Davey! Is he gonna give up right now? Look at the blood! Look at the blood that is on Davey! Chris Cordana is not letting go here. Oh my gosh! Oh. Chris Cordana tried to go for a European uppercut. Davey gave him a calf kick. Goodness, these guys are give. This is what KWX is all about, people. Not another one. Oh my gosh! A butterfly power driver. It is over. It is over. Chris Cordana just Guys, I do not know what the fuck we're seeing here tonight. We're seeing a lot of heart from this kid. We're seeing a lot of heart. Chris Cordana! What the fuck? Oh my god, the neck of Davey! Chris Cordana is fucking pumped! This kid has a lot of fucking heart. This kid is showing something that we haven't even seen. And really, in wrestling, Chris Cordana has got hurt with the most lethalest moves out of this wrestling business. And he gets up, and he's screaming, come on. My goodness, the fight you'll see from this kid. What the fuck is Chris Cordana? He's backing away. Oh, a spear! A spear onto the fucking barricade! Jesus! Chris Cordana, let's fucking go! Oh my goodness, Chris. The blood is still on his right hand. Davey's blood is still on the right hand. This is what KWX is all about, people. This is what it's all about. This is what truly is all about. This is the fight that these men have to do in order to get titles in this business. Just this fight that they have to get into. Rolls them back into the ring. Chris Cordon is getting into the ring. Davey's trying to get up. He looks fucking tired as fuck. Big right hand. Davey recovers from that. What is this? What is this? A glory bomb! Oh my gosh! His fucking head hitting his head hitting the bottom of that turnbuckle. What's Davey going for? Big headbutt! My goodness! Davey using his body to put punishment on Chris Cordon, a shooting star press. Jeez. A snapmare position. Oh my gosh, what a back elbow that was. Stunned Davey. Davey's not fucking stunned anymore. A nice punch. Right hands. These right hands. It's matching enough. Oh my gosh, a European uppercut. Davey's tired. But he's not tired enough to get this pin here. Two. It's over. Oh no! Chris Cordon again. Chris Cordon is kicking out. I must say, Chris Cordon, we're seeing something from this kid that we have not seen in wrestling in a while. We're seeing a lot of fight going into this. It's something that we've seen from Andy Ace early on tonight, but this shit is crazy. He's getting hit with big moves, and I've got Davey back in the inverted sharpshooter. I think this is the challenger that Davey wanted to have. A kid that's going to take him to the limits, but the thing is, it's a kid. You know, Chris Cordon, he's only 20 years old. Davey's in his 30s. What is this? What a overhead kick that was. Chris Cordon is out, but he's not out cold. Oh my gosh, Rose Dude gives him a European uppercut. Insane. Insane what these guys can pull off. Holy shit! Holy shit! He's got him in an arm! He's got him in an ankle lock! He's got Davey in an ankle lock! Oh my gosh! After the punishment, after Davey using his right leg throughout the whole entire match, now he's putting punishment on the left leg of Dynamite Davey. Dynamite Davey is tired, but oh my gosh! Sorry to interrupt you guys. We just had some type of glitch going on with the camera here, but Chris Cordon's been laying it in. Oh my gosh, that monkey flip. Laying it in. Oh, a swirling snap. Oh my gosh, a rolling neck snap that was. Chris Cordon has been laying it in on Davey. Davey has not been able to come back after getting off that ankle lock. Sorry for the interruption there. Oh, big uppercut. Davey's still fucking standing. Goodness, these right hands. Just look at the blood that is still on him. A back chop. My goodness. These men right here. This is what KWX is all about, people. This is what it's truly all about. I'm not making this up. You're going to see this shit. Oh, what an arm drag. Onto that steel chair. My goodness. This may be it. And this is Davey's debut. This is Davey and Chris Cordon's debut on the KWX. Oh, big forearm. No. No. Oh my gosh! No, on the steel chair! Oh, butterfly power drive onto that steel chair! That is it! It is fucking done! It is fucking done! It's over! Oh my gosh! Oh man, what a fucking match! What a match! What a match that we just saw here! What a fucking match! Dynamite Davey is going on to the next round. You gotta give your props up to Chris Cordon. This kid tried to fight. Much respect here. Even Davey has to give this kid respect. But anyway, you guys, see you guys on the next night of the Billion Dollar Championship Tournament on KWX. Hello, this is Marcus Baker, telling you to get your popcorn ready and get everything set for the next night of KWS. We have Andy Ace taking on Joshua Radix. Then We have Logan Stark going against Dynamite Davey, all for the Billion Dollar Championship. Be there ready for that, because I will. KWX.